could have given you all of my heart, but there's someone who's torn it apart, and she's taken almost all that I've got. But if you wanna try to love again, baby, I'll try to love again, but I know the first cut is the deepest. Baby, I know the first cut is the deepest. 'Cause when it comes to being lucky, she's cursed. When it comes to loving me, she's worse. But when it comes to being in love, she is first. That's how I know the first cut is the deepest. Baby, I know the first cut is the deepest.
Hey, how you doing? Justin here. Today we are checking out First Cut is the Deepest by Cat Stevens, or Yusuf Islam, if you're a new school kind of a dude. Beautiful tune. It's only got three chords in it. Just something to note though is that I always thought it went G, D, C, D all of the way through. In fact, I played it in bands, cover bands and stuff as a teenager like that. And only when I was researching for this book did I discover that actually there's some sections where it's a little different and it does sound a lot better to get it right. So just in case you were one of the people like me that just thought it had that one little chord sequence all of the way through. Let's get to a close-up and I'll show you how to play the little intro riff, because we use that for the verse as well. Sounds really cool and it's pretty easy to play. So there we have the little riff that we use for the intro and the verse. We're starting off with a third finger doing a little mini bar here on strings 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so covering just strings 2, 3, and 4 with the third finger. Remember to bring that kind of knuckle here forward a little bit if you're having trouble with that. Don't let it kind of pull back behind. Push that first knuckle forward there and that'll help you get a good set of notes. So we're just going to pluck the 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, 3rd string, okay? I tend to use alternate picking, down, up, all of the way through. But it really doesn't matter if you go down, up, down, up, you know, whatever feels comfortable. But alternate's a good place to start. So we start off with that one. This is a G chord. Then we go to a D chord, so we just leave kind of going onto the tip of our third finger, so third finger's on the 12th fret of the 4th string, second finger on the 11th fret of the 3rd string, and first finger on the 10th fret of the 2nd string. This is the middle part of a kind of a D chord like that. And we're going to play the same pattern, 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string, back to the 3rd string. But the kind of little quirk of the tune is that we slide up to it. Even though our third finger is already in position, we just slide up from 2 or 3 frets. Doesn't really matter how many frets exactly, but kind of, you know, 2 or 3. Slide. Then we move the whole shape back 2 frets. This would be a C chord. And then do a little slide again. G, D, C, slide. And again. Always with that little slide. Just on the D. So once you feel confident picking out that little riff there for the intro, you've got to deal with manipulating it so that you can use it for the verses. Because the verse is kind of based on that idea, but there's a few little changes that we need to make. So it starts off regular with the G, D, C, D, but then straight away, this is in the verse, it goes G, C, D, C. Then back to the regular pattern twice. So G, D, C, D. Again, G, D, C, D. But then the last time, G, C, D. Does it twice, and there's a little riff kind of thing goes in there on the D where it holds before the chorus. But it's really important that you get that order of the sequence. But important, I played it wrong for years and years and years, so it's not, I guess, that important. But I think it's a good idea to learn the tune properly, and I think now that I've learned it properly, I think it sounds a lot better. So one more time through that verse.
would have given you all of my heart. But there's someone who's seated to D. C. And she's G in almost D that I've seen. But D you want all C to love a D. C. Maybe I'll see G to do a C, but a D.
Into the chorus.
G, the first D is the C chord. Baby, I know the first C is the C chord. D, when it G to B and D, she's C to D. When it G to love and C, she's D. C. When it G to B and in D, she's C. That's D, I know that G. The first D is the C, yes. D and G, the first D is the C, yes. D.
And just watch out there on the original recording, there's a little 2-4 bar snuck in there just to make life difficult for us. So let me run through that chorus again, where we want to just jump to regular chords. It is, of course, very possible to play the verse without doing the riff up there as well. If you want to just strum it using regular chords, that totally works as well. But let's go through the chorus first. So chorus is G, the first, D is the C chord. To D. Baby, I'm G. The first D is the C chord. D. Cause when it G's to B and D, she's C. To D. And when it's G comes to love and C, she's the D.
That's the reverse bit, C. But when it G to B and in D, she's C. That's D, I know that G. The first D is the C chord. D, I know G. The first D is the C chord. D, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2.
And then we're back into our verses again. Okay, so that would be the thing that... It's just a little bit unusual where the C chord, where the chord progression changes from G, C, D, C. The only way that you're going to get it is by listening to it, playing along. Really good idea is to write chords out as well, you know, so that you can see the form easily. You know, even in, like in my songbook, you get the chords above the lyrics, which is really helpful, an essential way of doing it. But it can also be helpful just to write the chords out on their own so you can see the patterns really clearly. You know, I even made a little note on mine that the verse is normal, reverse, normal, normal, reverse. Okay, that's the way I remember that chord sequence. The chorus is normal, 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 reverse, normal, normal, reverse. Okay, that's just, you know, simplifying it like that. When I'm looking at my page, I can see straight away what the order of those chords are. You know, and it's pretty important. You know, after a little bit, now I can kind of remember, oh, it's three normals in the chorus, and then it's just one reverse and two normals. It makes it easier to recall because you can kind of create a little mental picture of the chord sequence. It can be very helpful. Hope you have a lot of fun playing this tune. I think it's a real cool one. And yeah, I'll see you for plenty more lessons and songs very soon. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.